Okay, it's April 5th at 10 a.m. We got cucumbers planted in three rows here. That one, that one, that one. And right down there where that, I'm not going to zoom in, but right there in the middle, there's a pumpkin planted there. This garden's not going to have plastic on it. We're probably going to plant more cucumber over here. I didn't mean pumpkin. I mean, those are three cucumber and then a pumpkin. Then we got space in here. I either have four, and I don't recall if I did four or six zucchini on this edge of the garden. It's between that tomato stake there and the edge. This one we haven't done anything yet. That'll be in a few days. We're gonna take this plastic up, till it, put the plastic back down. And this is cucumbers. We have garlic. 28 garlic plants. Two rows, and then we have three right here. In between these little tomato sticks here, I have two, one there, and then one got garlic somehow or another. Got started growing right there. So 28 garlic. Come back here. We did scarlet red giant bean, whatever it is. I put two of them down in that corner. I've been trying to grow these scarlet, out of the last 6 years twice. This is the third year. I put two down there. Put a little fencing. My little homemade fencing, because you're not going to be able to buy fencing, so you might as well learn how to do some of it. Then we have a Cherokee Trail of Tears, two beans, a Good Mother Starlard, Cherokee Good Mother Starlard. So we have two, four, or actually three, three, six, nine, 12 beans right here. Here we have what's a northern bean. Right here we got I got three fences up again. They're makeshift homemade. I got 3 foot by 50 foot, and I cut it in half, so it's 18 by 100 now total. So it was 100 by cutting in half, so 18 inches, which is more than enough for what we need for the crawl on. Four white beans. And we have two black-eyed peas here and here. And yesterday my wife planted some more beans. Oh gosh, my knees have been killing me doing this stuff. This is a Jackson Wonder bean. I put fences up for them. Right here, right here. Then we have butterscotch. And Mayflower. Mayflower in that hole, Mayflower that with two of each one. And butterscotch, and then the Jackson Wonder, we got two and two. Okay, I've got three more fences, approximately 4 foot, 5 foot length. As you can see, with the wind out here, I don't know if you can hear it, everything. It's chicken wire, it's a fencing, not chicken wire, it's fencing. It was 3 foot by 50 foot, cut down the middle, so it's double. It's 100 foot of 18 inches. And I just used tomato stakes to make stakes to put the fencing in. Weaving it through and on the ends, try to bend them, and then I get bent out, and I don't have my gloves, so I'm not going to mess with the ends. Get gloves on and get some wire pliers or something. So that's what we have out here right now. Like I say, this one's going to be, the plastic's going to be taken up, and we're going to till it, get these, what I call tree trunks from the okra from last year, out of here. Watermelon and cantaloupe in May, we're going the middle part, just beyond the middle, going east. That east is that direction. So right here is the two black-eyed peas. And then we'll probably put, I think I have three or four cantaloupe and then five watermelon plants are gonna go here. We've got okra and pumpkin over there. And we're gonna see, because again, with all this out here, running out here doing this stuff again without writing it down, I never learn. We'll have it, because we have abundance this year. We should have a very good garden. And we got some spies up here somewhere. I have lots of drones. I hear drones out here all the time. That's a helicopter though. I hear it's probably an army helicopter because it's, no, it's not. Yeah, it is. It looks like one of the most short ones. Huh. There you go. Still don't think you live in a police state? Stupid. Anyway, So far, that's what we got. And in the back here, I don't know if we're going to put anything, but these, from the black eyed peas over to where those beans are that Tracy planted yesterday. Yesterday. We could put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more beans back there. And then, like I said, cantaloupe, watermelon. We've got okra and pumpkin over there. So this will be where I'm going to put tomatoes and peppers. And along the house, we might put some peppers. Not as many, because they didn't do well at all last year. The year before, they did pretty decent. I still like to put maybe about 9 pepper plants along the house. Alternate rows here with peppers and tomatoes. I'm going to turn around when I get up here off the garden. You know, but peppers on the outside rows. Tomato, maybe tomato, pepper, tomato, tomato, pepper, tomato, pepper, tomato, like that across here. Depending on how many are going to come out really good. Next weekend, we're going to plant the tomatoes inside. We've got some growing now. I mean, my God. We have to transplant them into bigger planters. So we got peppers, a few peppers and tomatoes in the house growing. Got some eggplant growing, at least 2 of the 4. So that's another thing that'll come out here. Eggplant will probably go in this garden too. This is garden number 1. That's garden number 2 without the plastic this year. And garden number 3 in the back. Beans, peas. Then it'll be cantaloupe, watermelon, okra, and pumpkin. So, and like I say, peppers, tomatoes here, and then see what we're going to do with this over here by the house. This was going to be like a raised bed I was going to do, but I'd have to get like 20 bags. 20 bags to get this raised up. I got to move that cinder block. I'm using the cinder block. I'm going to go to Lowe's and buy about 12 by this weekend, and then I got 12 next year, next month. So I have 24 to use for odd things, like around the border for the plastic. The back one back there, the plastic was blown off by the winds we had out here. I have an earlier video, you'll see it. But I had to come out here 11:30 at night, drop my cane because I couldn't do carrying that in the cane. Drop my cane limping from right over there, you can see in the back. Where's the zoom at on this thing? Right back there, there was a pile of cinder blocks in the back, kind of that moron. All the way to the back over there, and drop one, go back, you know, and so I put out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them, 11:30 at night, limping my butt off out here. The winds out here were strong. I keep looking at that BS on Weatherbug. This is 5 to 7 mile an hour. No way. I mean, you might have a 5 to 7 mile hour break for a few seconds. Winds usually out here are around 10, 15 miles. And then you have wind gusts on top of that. So we had stuff out here on the previous video. I thought there was a tornado out here. I swear to you, I did. It knocked that blue tote. We got this table in front of it now. But that blue tote, which is not heavy, but it's not light. It knocked stuff out there on here across the yard. That blue tote was 150 feet. 125 feet into that field over there. Not the green, but just beyond the green there in that field. So the winds out here are very damaging. And it didn't do a lot of damage to some things, but then on the other things, I have got pieces of roofing that came off too. So, and Lucy being blind, we got this little makeshift runner for her right now with a leash wrapped around a couple of our hummingbird hooks. And her leash will go across it so she can run back and forth here. So Tracy cleared out a lot of this stuff. We got some more solar lights out here. Those flowers just came up in 4 days. Those light green ones, that one she transplanted, one of those over there in the other garden. So that's what I got done. And today is, like I said, April 5th. It's about 5 minutes or 10 minutes after 1, after 10. So that's it.